गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज राहुल गर्ग, योर साइंस टीचर, एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज हीट एंड टेम्परेचर, एंड दिस इज फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट, मोड्स ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर, in which we have discussed that the method by which heat is transferred from one object to another is known as modes of heat transfer. And we have three types of modes. First one is conduction, second one is convection, and the third one is radiation. Then we discussed about conduction, which is the transfer of heat without actually movement of any material or substance. Means in conduction, there is no movement of particles, only heat is transferred through the electrons. Then we have discussed why metals are good conductor of heat, whereas non-metals are poor conductor. This is because of metals have free electrons, whereas non-metals doesn't have free electrons, due to which metals transfer heat easily. And today we will discuss about convection. The second mode of heat transfer is convection. As you know, conduction takes place in solids, whereas convection takes place in liquids and gases, and both together are known as fluids. These are known as fluids. Solids, in solids there is conduction, there is a transfer of heat through the conduction. But in liquid and gases, the mode of heat transfer, that is convection. Now, we know that liquids and gas are poor conductor of heat. So, in liquid and gas, heat doesn't transfer through conduction, it transferred by convection. Now, what is convection? Convection is the transfer of heat from one place to another by the movement of fluid. How it take place? Let's discuss with the help of diagram. Suppose these arrows shows the heat. Now my heat is transferred. To this layer. That is with the red pen, that this is the my heat transfer to this layer. And now if heat is transferred to this layer, then this will become lighter, its density will become light, its density will get reduced. So we know that if an object has lighter density, have less density, then it starts floating on the higher density object. Now this layer will start moving upward, and the adjacent layer, means the layer adjacent to this, that is the shown with the green, this layer will come down, will touch the bottom, and this red layer that is already heated goes on the upside, whereas the green one become at the bottom side. Now again the green will become hot, and again this will rise up, and similarly the process will continue till all the fluid, it may be liquid or gas, get hot. So in this the movement of fluid is taking place. My fluid is flowing from lower part, that is the part which is directly in contact with the heat. This will become heat up, and then its density will get reduced, and this will float on the upper layers, and hence the whole fluid will get warm. So in convection, heat is transferred from one place, means from bottom to this side, from one place to another by the movement of fluids. Similarly, this will take place in gases. If this is liquid, similarly in gases, the lower portion will get heat up and then the upper portion. Now, to generalize this, we assume that here the temperature is 75 degrees Celsius, then here the temperature will be less, say 74 or say then 60 degrees Celsius. Means as we move away from the heat up portion, away from the contact portion where the heat contacts, the temperature is decreasing. Means the highest temperature will be at the bottom part. स्टूडेंट्स, आपने नोट भी किया होगा कि जब भी हम कोई मिल्क को या वाटर को बॉयल करते हैं तो सबसे पहले नीचे वाला जो पोर्शन है वो गर्म होता है, उसके ऊपर वाला जो पोर्शन होता है, ऊपर वाला जो फ्लूइड होता है वो क्या होता है, एज कंपेयर टू बॉटम वो कोल्ड होता है. तो क्या होता है कि थोड़े टाइम बाद वो वहां से बबल्स निकलना स्टार्ट होते हैं. वो इसी वजह से होते हैं कि नीचे वाला जो बॉटम पोर्शन से जो पार्टिकल्स हैं वो लाइटर हो जाते हैं, उनकी डेंसिटी रिड्यूस हो जाती है. द डेंसिटी गेट रिड्यूस एंड दे कम्स ऑन द अपर साइड एंड द बबल्स गेट कम आउट. नाउ कन्वेक्शन, द मूविंग वाटर फॉर्म्स अ करंट कॉल्ड अ कन्वेक्शन करंट. दिस इज करंट मीन्स फॉलोइंग. दिस इज नॉट द इलेक्ट्रिकल करंट. This is about the current that is moving. Its meaning a means is moving. So the moving water forms a current called convection current. In the convection, the flow of movement or the flow of water is known as convection current, which carries the heat energy around the flask. Flask means a container in which the liquid is placed. Now, gases expands much more than liquids. We know that gas expand means expansion, means they occupy more space. Gases expand much more than a liquid. Greater change in the density of hot gases create faster. मतलब कि अगर density में जो change है वो ज्यादा होगा तो जो रेट ऑफ ट्रांसफर है ऑफ हीट है, मतलब जितना फास्ट, जितना ज्यादा जल्दी वो चेंज डेंसिटी में आएगा उतनी ही फास्ट क्या होगा, हीट ट्रांसफर होगा. एंड स्ट्रॉन्गर कन्वेक्शन करंट्स इन गैसेस, मींस अगर गैसेस एक्सपैंड जल्दी हो रही है, मींस उसमें जो डेंसिटी का जो गैप है, जो चेंज है वो ज्यादा आ रहा है, तो वहां पे जो कन्वेक्शन ऑफ करंट है, जो कन्वेक्शन करंट है वो ज्यादा होगा. So convection occurs more readily in gases as compared to liquids. The third point is the movement of hot air and cold air set up a current convection. This we have seen in the cold breeze or hot breeze. This is current convection. Daytime here on the seaside, this is the cool air, and on the land side here the warm air. So heat is, so the current convection means the flow of transfer of air will be from like this, anti-clockwise, means from land to sea, from land to sea. This is daytime. And in whereas in night time this is reverse. In the night time the land is cool as compared to water, seaside. So the flow will be reverse. Here this is anti-clockwise, this will be clockwise. Now the application of convection. Our first application, first uses of convection is इलेक्ट्रिक किटल. इन इलेक्ट्रिक किटल द बॉटम पार्ट इज कंटेनिंग अ हीटर एंड वेयर द वॉटर और एनी लिक्विड गेट हॉट एंड राइजेज अप. वेयर एज द अपर पार्ट सिंक्स डाउन एंड द होल फ्लूइड्स और होल लिक्विड और वॉटर प्लेस इन द किटल गेट हॉट. And the second is ventilation in homes and buildings. We know that we are in the room or in a building, we are provided with a ventilator. Why these ventilators are provided? Because the hot air coming from our body, warm air emitted from our body, warms the surrounding air. And then the surrounding air will get heat up, and due to the density difference, the hot air surrounding us will rises up, and the cold air entering through the ventilator will comes down, and this will make the home or house fresh. And the third is in air conditioner. Air conditioner means AC that we use in the summer time. The AC you notice that ACs are air conditioner are placed at the top of the wall, because at the bottom the air will be cold. When the surrounding air, that is the when heat is emitted from our body, it heat up the surrounding air, and the surrounding air will rises up, and when it reaches to near the air conditioner, it will get cooled down, and then again it sinks down. Means agar hamari body mein se heat niklegi to wo surrounding air ko heat up karegi, jiski wajah se jo surrounding air hai warm ho jayegi, aur uski jo density hai lighter hone ki wajah se wo upar ki taraf move karegi. और जब वो एसी के पास पहुंचेगी तो दोबारा वो क्या हो जाएगी, कूल्ड हो जाएगी. ठंडी होने के बाद फिर उसमें डेंसिटी इंक्रीज हो जाएगी, फिर वो नीचे आ जाएगी. ऐसे कंप्लीट सर्कल चलता रहता है. और एयर कंडीशन क्या करता है, कंप्लीट रूम की जो वार्म एयर है उसको कोल्ड में कन्वर्ट कर देता है. नाउ द फोर्थ वन इज रूम हीटर. दिस इज द रिवर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ एयर कंडीशनर. सो रूम हीटर आर placed as low as possible, because in this the reverse phenomena is required. And the fifth one is hot water system and refrigerator. In hot water system and refrigerator system, phenomena is same, that is a convection. And in sea breeze and land breeze, that we have discussed in the last slide, that is the sea breeze or land breeze. Sea breeze is during the daytime. Sea breeze occurs during daytime, and the land breeze occurs at the night time. Okay, student. Thank you and have a nice day.